Thy mask and grin in darkness bright, I summon forth the one of fright, mime of shadowed blight. Return to us this Halloween night.
If I was a devil, if I were the Prince of Darkness, I'd want to engulf the whole world in darkness. And I'd have a third of its real estate and four-fifths of its population, but I wouldn't be happy until I'd seize the ripest apple on the tree. See? So I'd set out, about however necessary, to take over the United States. I'd subvert the churches first. I'd begin with a campaign of whispers. With the wisdom of a serpent, I would whisper to you as I whisper to Eve. Do as you please. To the young, I would whisper that the Bible is a myth. I will convince them that man created gods and the other way around. I will confide that what's bad is good, and what's good is square. And the old, I would teach to pray, after me, our Father, which art in Washington. And then I'd get organized. I'd educate authors on how to make lewd literature exciting, so that anything else would appear dull and interesting. I'd threaten TV with dirtier movies and vice versa. I'd peddle narcotics to whom I could. I'd sell alcohol to ladies and gentlemen of distinction. I'd tranquilize the rest with pills. If I were the devil, I'd soon have families at war with themselves, churches at war with themselves, and nations at war with themselves, until each in its turn was consumed. And with promises of higher ratings, I'd have mesmerizing media fanning the flames. If I were the devil, I would encourage schools to redefine young intellects, but neglect to discipline emotions. Just let those run wild. Until before you knew it, you'd have to have drug-sniffing dogs and metal detectors at every schoolhouse door. Within a decade, I'd have prisons overflowing. I'd have judges promoting pornography. And soon as I could evict God from the courthouse, and then from the schoolhouse, and then from the House of Congress. And in his own churches, I would substitute psychology for religion and deify science. I would lure priests and pastors into misusing boys and girls and church money. And if I were the devil, I'd make the symbols of Easter an egg and the symbol of Christmas a bottle. If I were the devil, I'd take from those who have and give to those who want it until I kill the incentive of the ambitious. In other words, if I were the devil, I'd just keep right on doing what he's doing.
Yeah. Take that, you little shit. Oh, I love this little game. Oh, who could that be? Hello, Dylan's Deals. How can I help you?
Hey, gorgeous. Just wanted to hear your voice before I start the show.
Well, if it isn't my favorite DJ. I'm listening to the station right now. How's the pre-show vibe?
The studio's all set for tonight. It's gonna be one of those nights, you know? I'm feeling pumped, but enough about me. How's your day been?
Busy, but good. Dylan's over the moon. We just got a set of really fancy sports cars in. I'm just about to wrap up and head to Maggie's party.
I wish I could join you sooner, but I'll be there as soon as I'm done.
You just make sure you save some energy for me after you finish up your show tonight.
You're talking to Billy Knight, Crimson Ridge's most dashing DJ. So don't you worry. No, it looks like the show's about to start. I gotta run, sweet thing. I'll see you later.
I'll be waiting. Good luck with the show.
Hey there, Nightcrawlers! This is Billy Knight, your guide through the ghoulish and ghostly.
Join me tonight for a special Halloween broadcast to make your skin crawl and your heart race. We got bone-chilling tracks, terrifying tales, and a few tricks up our sleeve. Don't miss out on the Crimson Ridge's most haunted tradition here on 105.5 The Tude, where Halloween comes alive, even if you don't make it through the night.
He sounds so good. I can't wait to see him later. Dylan wanted me to do a few things before closing for the night. I should check the whiteboard and see what I need to do. Looks like the first thing I need to do is install tire locks on those new sports cars we just got in. Man, who wants ice cream this late? Anyway, I need to store those inflatable tubes in the shed. Now I just need to shut off the car lot lights. What the? Hello? Hello? Is anyone there? If this is some kind of prank, it's not funny. What? What was that? Ugh, it's just a car alarm. Probably just a raccoon or something. What? That's not supposed to happen. A malfunction, maybe? No way. Is that the ice cream truck I just saw drive by? Just stop like that? Okay, that's enough. Who's in there? No more jokes.
Why do I have to work on Halloween again this year? What a drag. At least Phil is showing one of my favorites tonight. Nosferatu is a classic. Oh yeah, Ben's working with me tonight. That should make things a bit more interesting. Well, I better head inside. My shift starts soon. Damn, that was my last cig. I better grab another pack from the gas station before work.
Mika, working over at the Mirage tonight?
Hey, Oscar. Yeah, Phil is doing his yearly Midnight Horror Mania event.
Huh. Sounds spooky. What can I do you for tonight?
Can I just get some reds and a lighter?
Sure thing, one sec. Here you go. That'll be $6.49.
Thanks, Oscar. Have a good night. What's up, Ben? Working the box office tonight, I see.
Hey! Yeah, you know how it goes. But who knows what kind of ghouls and ghosts are gonna float in.
Right. Halloween is the perfect night for some spooky movies. I'm ready for the costumes.
Bill loves throwing these Halloween events every year. I kinda wish we had the night off, though. I can think of a few things we could be doing instead.
Yeah, I was ready to watch some slashers tonight, but what can you do? I just wish we weren't so short-staffed. His events can get kinda hectic.
Speaking of, Bill said he had a couple of jobs for you to do before we open. He should be up in his office.
All right, I'll head up then. Catch you later.
The killer was barely in this, but I kinda liked it that way. Too many plots for one movie.
The trailer for this movie was scarier than the movie was. I hate it when that happens. I could smell the gore in this movie. I loved it.
Pretentious trash. Just goes to show that big name actors don't make a horror movie good. The twist in this one made me love the director a lot more.
I love when the final girl plays mind games with the killer. How's it going tonight, Phil? Ben told me you needed to see me.
Good evening, Mika. Yes, you'll be running the snack bar tonight, but I need you to do a couple of things before we open.
Sure, what do you need me to do?
I borrowed a box of vinyls from Billy over at the station across the street. I need you to take it back. Once you do that, I need you to empty all the trash and take it to the dumpster out back.
Sounds good, I'll get right on it.
Oh, and after you take the trash out, I need you to grab the test footage from Eric down in the basement, and then run it on the projector.
Sure thing, boss.
Awesome. Thanks.
Hello? Who's there? The lobby is closed for the night.
Kelly, it's Nika. Phil asked me to return some of Billy's records.
Nika? Sure, I'll buzz you in. I'm in my office. Just head on back.
Hey, Kelly. Happy Halloween.
Nika, hey. You're looking fantastic tonight.
Yeah. How's the broadcast going?
Oh, you know Billy. He loves burning the midnight oil. Are you working with Ben tonight? I don't know why he hasn't asked you on a date yet.
Stop it, Kelly. I think he's just a little shy.
I'm just saying. He better make a move before somebody else does.
Sure, Kelly. You'll be the first to know. So where do you want these records?
You can just leave them on top of the boxes right there, next to the filing cabinets. I'll take them over to Billy when he goes on break.
Okay, stay safe tonight.
You too. Have a wonderful evening.
Head back to the theater and gather all the trash.
Excuse me, young lady? Can you spare some change?
Shit! Don't sneak up on people like that.
Please, young lady, help an old drunk get his booze for Halloween.
You know you're not supposed to be back here. This is private property.
Yeah, forget you, you ugly little bitch!
Damn it, I don't know how he keeps getting through the gate. I better tell Eric to double check the lock. He should be.
Hey, Nika! Happy Halloween!
How's it going, Eric? You seem super mellow right now.
Oh, yeah. Nothing's gonna harsh my vibe tonight. That's for sure. Let's just say I got my hands on some pretty high-quality brownies. You could have one if you like.
You can save one for me later. The last time I had one of your treats at work, I spent hours staring at all the movie posters, completely ignoring every customer.
No worries. Anyway, what brings you down to my quarter of the world?
Phil sent me to grab the footage to test the projector before tonight's event.
I don't know why he's so worried. It's right here on the table. Should be good to go.
Thanks, Eric. Oh, by the way, I ran into that guy hanging around the dumpster again.
Oh, bummer. You want me to head out back and lock everything up?
Yeah, please, just make sure it's actually locked this time. He keeps getting through somehow.
Thank you.
Wow, that was actually kind of creepy. I'm all done up here. I should get down to the snack bar. The doors are opening soon. Fuck! I'll tell Eric about that later.
Well, that was fucking weird.
I need to stock these new black magic displays. All the products should be in the boxes out the back in the shipping container. Over this barrel. What, did you think that was funny? Scram! Before I come out there and kick your ass! Should do it. I should return to the register. Welcome to Falcon Fuel. What can I do for you?
Dude, I really need to use the bathroom. Where is it?
No. Bathrooms are for paying customers only.
Come on, man. I'm gonna explode here. I just need to go for a second.
Rules are rules, buddy. You gotta buy something.
Fine. I'll buy something after. Just give me the key.
Nice try. I've heard that before. No pay, no pee.
Fine. I'll buy something right now. What's the cheapest thing you got?
Gum's a buck, Fitty. Why don't you grab a pack?
Keep the change. Just give me the key.
Here you go. Enjoy your bathroom break.
Ugh, I hate this place.
The freaks are out tonight, that's for sure.
Fuck, man. I need a piss. Oh, yeah. That's better. What the fuck? This shitter is occupied. What the fuck? Look, man, I don't want any trouble. What the hell are you? Please, dude, just leave me alone.
On the radio.
Good evening, ghouls and goblins. You're tuned into the spookiest station in town, 101.5 The Tune. I'm your host, Billy Knight, here to haunt your airwaves on this Halloween night, just after the witching hour strikes. And boy, do we have a bone-chilling treat for you tonight. If you're not already trembling with excitement, let me tell you about the frightful festivities happening right here in our town. The Mirage, our local theater, is hosting a midnight movie horror marathon featuring all your favorite spine-tingling classics. So if you dare, grab popcorn and head over there for a night of terror on the big screen. But fear not, my fellow night owls, because we've got the perfect soundtrack to accompany you on your Halloween escapades. Coming up next, we've got a killer lineup of rocking tracks to keep your heart pounding and your toes tapping. So stay tuned, my fellow creatures of the night, as we keep the spooky vibes alive right here on 101.5 The Tune!
What was that? Sounded like something fell over in the garage. I better go check it out. What a mess. What the hell happened here? Who's there? Sick joke is this? Wait.
We'll be right back.
Damn it! There's gotta be some fucking booze or money around here somewhere.